Hello everyone, welcome to our channel. So today our topic is going to be bull markets. So what are these bull markets? These are also basically related to any financial market or stock market or securities market. But why we call it as a bull market is based upon how the stock prices are being there. So we'll first discuss on why it is named as bull market. If you take a bull, how it will attack its enemies? It will thrust up his horn and then try to attack. So basically the horn just moves in the upward direction, right? So similar way, the bull just thrust up his horn towards upward direction before attacking its enemy. The similar way, the stock prices will get higher. Will keep on getting higher in a financial market, be a stock price or in a securities or cash or whatever be the thing. In the any finance market, if the stock prices are rising up high continuously, effectively, and or is a case where it is expected to rise sooner in near future, okay, those kind of markets we refer it as bull market. Okay, so how this happens? Is it happening automatically, or is there any timeline when it will happen? Okay, if you ask me that question, basically this kind of bull markets, right, before seeing a rise in the stock prices, okay, the financial rates, they will be definitely seeing a decline of 20% in their prices. I mean, the price fall will happen at least two times with a range of 20%. So post which there is a chance and there is an optimistic behavior which will be observed in that kind of financial markets, where the stock prices keeps on going high, and that high prices will be ranging mostly like 20% high, and it will be in a consistent manner. So consistently it will start grow. Okay, so how this stock prices keeps on going high, like how the bull is keeping the horns upward, right? So the on the upward direction, on the higher side, higher front, on the profitable front, the share prices or stock prices consistently they keep on increasing. So what are those things that are majorly affecting and making this bull markets to be in place? If you see, right, they are not like all of a sudden happen. As we are seeing, some decline will be observed in that kind of market, and post which it will start to emerge. So the investors, the other participants majorly who are part of the particular market, are responsible for this. Basically the investors and other parties who are already part of that particular financial market where the bull market strategy is being observed, that is going to result as a bull market. So how it happens, right? There are like major factors to be observed. The very first is the economical growth. Economical growth. So they'll keep on watching the overall economical growth of that geographical area. Plus the unemployment rate going down. The unemployment rate going down or getting to zero level at the max. These two things basically will form like a kind of a base to decide that, and using this the investor confidence increases. Investor confidence increases over that market. So due to this confidence, right, the supply and demand chain gets affected. If you see, supply and demand chain get affected. Let me explain how it is. As I see a economical growth and unemployment to be in place, which will often result in huge profits, okay, and a strong GDP, resulting in huge profits and a strong GDP. Gross domestic product value, all these things while seeing, right, the initial public offerings will become more, the IPO list will become more. So upon analysis of all these things, the investor confidence will increase. What they do, they tend to invest more. So they tend to invest more in the sense the demand becomes big but the supply becomes small. A kind of seesaw manner, okay. One way demand will be on a higher note on a seesaw end, and the other end the supply will go down. In layman terms, people want to buy shares or those whatever being traded in that market, but selling shares will go down. This will go up, this will go down, which will eventually result in the affecting of supply and demand chain. They won't be equal. So due to this, investor confidence being increased due to the economical growth, unemployment, IPOs being more in number, thereby seeing many profits and strong GDP values, right? All these things combinedly, they just result in buying of more shares from the investor end. So buying of more shares in the investor end, the overall demand start to goes high. So making the stock or share price higher and higher day by day. So that is how the consistent growth, what we are talking is here, the consistent growth we are able to observe in the bull market. Because when there is a demand is high and supply is not able to meet up, that market usually will be of higher price, right? So that is how this bull market is being maintained. So a reason, kind of example we can take, right? So from 2003 to 2007, housing loan platform, that kind of loan market was seeing a kind of huge increase. The supply and demand chain got affected as we discussed now, and the housing loan rates were very huge at that time. So this is how to a certain longer amount of period, if you take this itself, coming to 3 to 4 years, right? So basically this bull market is a long term market and it's a profitable market, and it is purely based on investor confidence. They don't do it just like that. They just don't have the confidence and invest in anything. They see the hidden factors like the economical growth, unemployment, how the supply and demand chains are going. They just try to tend to predict that. And upon analysis, they come to decide and make it as a successful bull market. Okay. Hope you all got an idea of what is a bull market. Thanks for watching this video, guys. For more interesting topics, please stay tuned in. If you find this topic interesting, please share it to your friends. Take care. Until then, it's your VK signing off. Bye bye.